Good morning, boys and girls. Today we are going to learn how to make our own rain stick or shaker at our house. So this is the rain stick or shaker you've probably seen at with my in my classroom that we use. All right, we could use it to shake and make some of these sounds. But we're going to learn how to make our own at home. So here are some things that you're going to need. If you have toilet paper or a paper towel, roll the inside of it or anything that you can find that kind of has a circle and an empty inside. You are going to need scissors, any kind of tape, any kind of paper you may have laying around your house. And then you'll need something to put inside the rain stick or the shaker to make noises. Today, I chose to use my leftover Cheerios. Okay, our first step is gonna be to wrap our rain stick in construction paper or regular paper. I'm gonna make mine green. So I'm gonna wrap my stick in my construction paper. Then I'm gonna take a piece of tape to close it up. You could use one piece or you could use more. I think I'm gonna put two more pieces just to hold it there. Okay, if there's leftover paper on the top, just push it in and fold it over the top. Do that on the other side as well. Okay, now I have my pretty outside of my shaker or rain stick. When we're finished, if you want, you could decorate the outside with crayons or pencils or anything that you have. For our second step, we have to cover the top of our rain stick. So I'm gonna cut a little square from my white paper. You could also use a balloon or a plastic bag or tissue paper. You can use anything for this step. So I'm gonna go ahead and cover one side of my rain stick. I could use a rubber band to go around it, or I could just tape it down so that it's nice and stuck to the bottom or top of my rain stick. So I'm gonna put that off to the side. I'm gonna grab some tape. Go. Okay. So now one side of my rain stick is closed. Nothing will be able to fall out. One side is still open. I'm gonna stick some of my Cheerios into the open side. You can stick as many or as little as you want. I think that's how many I want. So now I have a closed side and an open side. I don't want to shake it until I close the other side of my stick. So I'm going to go ahead and cut another square. Put this part on the top of my rain stick and tape it down again. Okay, now both sides of my shaker or rain stick have to be closed. All right, let's see what it sounds like. And now I have my own shaker or rain stick to use at my house. If you choose to make one, send your teacher a picture so I can see your shaker or rain stick that you made at home.